electoral college, I know that it's how we elect our presidents.
I know that there's a lot of controversy surrounding the electoral college simply because like Hillary Clinton won the popular vote and Donald Trump still won the vote in the electoral college.
So the electoral college is like the population votes, and then we have superdelegates, I think is what they're called. And then like those are the people who actually vote for the president, and there's like 500 something of them, and then the majority of that gets the presidency.
It basically feels like the popular vote just doesn't have a say.
It's been like looked down upon recently because it's not based on the popular vote. It's more of just like based on how large a state is, and a lot of states just get more votes because they have more people, and it kind of excludes smaller states and everything like that. But the weight is kind of is unevenly distributed. I should say that.
I mean, basically, like I have the understanding that we technically get to vote, but then overall, like it's up to the Electoral College. So there's kind of a flaw in that, in a sense, because like you're not actually your voices aren't actually fully represented as they should be.
I do know that that's the Trump one though, like versus the popular vote, which I think is a little, you know, kind of goes against the whole your vote matters thing.
I think having a system that works better and is more probably fair in representing the actual beliefs of the Americans would be a good idea.
Like, if 4 million more people want one person and then the Electoral College elects a different person, that's a problem.
I understand why it's in place. I think we could definitely consider different ways of doing it, but I don't think abolishing it is the correct move. There's a reason that it's there to make sure that, to condense everything and to put it all into place. And so I don't think abolishing it is the correct move. But there's room to investigate.